So come on, viewers, keep Ahmed in.
I think our mania is just about to kick off.
Yes! Did you get that?
Maid of honor, Ahmed. Housemate leaves. Unfortunately, the super fan must leave as well. Before we do that, before the dream is over, we allow them one final request. Now, the most famous moment of Big Brother 5, arguably, was the plate smashing on day 13.
Okay.
Yvonne has requested she gets to plate smash with you. Can we do that after
yes!
the break? Yes! Fantastic. Yeah. Okay. We'll see you after this break for a really smashing third party in a minute. Boys looking all buff. Welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. I hope you're very well. Still to come, we're offering you a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, unless we do it again, to hire Ahmed for the day. But first, it's time for Ahmed's superfan Yvonne to live the dream. Before Yvonne departs the BBLB studio for the final time, she gets to smash some plates with Ahmed. Are we ready for this, guys?
Sure. Yeah.
How are we feeling?
Excited.
Good stuff. Now, I have to stress, please, these are very special plates, so they won't kill us if they hit us or something like that. So make sure you don't do this at home at all. Okay. Like you ever would. Okay, firstly, I think we need a bit of music. So can we cue the music? Oh, hello. Ahmed, first off you go.
Hey!
Oh, lovely. Come on.
I'm not a sandwich!
Fire at will.
We are mad.
Yeah!
And we are happy about it.
Yeah!
Unfortunately, now you have to leave the Big Brother set forever.
Bye.
No!
No, well, thank you.
We miss you.
See you soon. Bye.
I'll make more for you later on. Yeah. Wonderful. Very exciting. Look, there are little bits of plate everywhere in the studio. It's going absolutely mental. Alex Zane's been spotting for us for the last 20 minutes or so. Alex, what's been going on?
Can you read this writing?
Yeah, of course I can.
It's terrible writing.
It's not, it's shorthand.
Okay, go for it.
Basically, it's as though they heard my movie pitch earlier, because down here we have Stu talking about what it would be like to live off the land if the world became a wilderness.
Hello.
And he's asked Shell how many cows he'd need to eat a day to survive, to which Shell replied, one.
A whole cow a day?
Well, yeah.
What? Shell's is wider than Marcus too, isn't it?
That's true. Probably. I might have misquoted Shell there. I think she said one or less. And Stu, because they're making bread in the kitchen, called it a bread factory, then revised that to a bakery, because there is only two of them making
Stu
bread.
Stu watch for you today, isn't it?
Well, there's been a lot of Stu on. And there was also a very homoerotic thing, not unlike the volleyball scene in Top Gun, where Jason there operated a mangle for Dan, which was interesting.
I saw a shot of that a minute ago. It looked kind of nice.
The other thing is that more bad news for Michelle. More weight to my anti-Michelle argument. She went up and hugged Stu while he was busy making bread. Busy, and she just wanders over and goes, "How about some hugs, Stu?"
Mistake. What does Stu say to that?
Well, obviously he hugged her because he's under the thumb.
Exactly. Get back to watching you. More from you later on. Last week we offered you a double whammy of Marco and Emma for hire. This Wednesday, we're offering up the chance for one lucky viewer to get hands on Ahmed. There we go, look at that. Happy there, Ahmed?
Yeah!
What's not to be happy about? All offers to be considered. The winner gets Ahmed and a BBLB camera crew for company. Remember, Ahmed doesn't like sentry duty, so no soldiering or security work of any kind. Email your job offers to bblb@channel4.com. Okay, thanks, cheerleaders. You can stop shushing now. Yeah, they're just not listening to me. Love it. Okay, they're not just pretty faces. They're beautiful faces. But irrespective of that, give us their take on something that happened in the house this week. Normally we talked about the task with you. Today's no exception. The housemates faced a live challenge yesterday which involved steps, general knowledge and fish. A bit of a twist there as well. Michelle was then offered all the money back if she drank a fish shake. She said no. Then everyone else was offered it, all £5,000 of it back if they drank it. They drank it, which means the prize total is down now to down, 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 down. Nice touch. Ooh, look at us. We're rich. We don't know what this drink. Me. I eat fish though, and chicken sometimes.
But that's the most annoying thing if you're a vegetarian. Mm. Most vegetarians don't do that. So when you say I'm vegetarian, people say, "Oh, would you like some fish?" No, yeah. Just don't eat any meat at all. Oof.
Okay, Pamela, Stu tried to drink it, and he couldn't. Jason is a supposed hard man. He should have necked the shake and saved them £5,000. Why didn't he?
I don't think he should have done it at all. I think he was right in not doing it. I wouldn't drink it
personally. £5,000, look at it!
Yeah, but is it worth... £5,000 isn't worth making yourself sick for.
Well, yes, it is. Okay, Glenn, Stuart's general knowledge again let him down. Which vowel does not appear in the top row of a keyboard?
You.
There we go, lovely. The answer is A.
That was close.
And Tom, to cheer everyone up, Shell made a roast dinner. Is she just trying to keep everyone sweet?
She's being the same Shell as always. She's there when it gets hard.
Okay, boring. Fair enough. Okay, still to come, we look through the papers, but first a quick recap of today's news. Jason surprises us all by announcing who he thinks deserves to win the most. That'd be Nadia. The housemates fail the most disgusting Big Brother task of all time and lose £15,000 in the process. And Stu saves the day as he protects the ladies and an unexpected guest. A spider. Joining me now on the sofa is freelance journalist Michael Holden and, of course, Ahmed. Yeah. Can we get a special woo for that Michael writes for The Guardian?
Woo!
And is here talking to us.
You meant more of an ooh than a woo, didn't you?
Well, I don't mind. Ooh or woo, I'll take what I get.
Okay.
Okay, now, in the past, the broadsheets have tended to get on the bandwagon against Big Brother. Why is it different this year? I mean, there's a great piece in G2 this week about you.
Really?
Yeah.
I think it's because you really haven't had to do much work as a journalist. In the past, things have been a little bit slower. And, you know, one might have to speculate more as to the whatever was or wasn't going on, whereas this year there's been such a flood of eccentricity that one only has to really sit back and watch and loosely describe it. Mm. You've got enough editorial mileage out of the antics of yourself and your incarcerated colleagues in the house.
OK, now be honest. People at The Guardian really watch Big Brother, and not in a kind of guilty pleasure way.
Well, I wouldn't want to speak on behalf of, you know, hundreds of staff. But I think you're probably in the middle ground on a paper like The Guardian or The Independent in the sense you're not seeking to occupy the moral high ground, and you're not desperately trying to get sort of loose entertainment stories as well. So you can kind of put your toe in the water, certainly
sure.
In the section that I work for.
You know. Okay, and as a writer, what side of Big Brother interests you most?
It's interesting because when things like this go on, you really don't have to work too hard, like I was saying. It's always interesting to report it and to speculate on it, but this has almost been a joy not to have to do too much writing about it, because you can just cover it in straight reporting. It's almost more like a genuine event than something that needs to be talked up.
Hear that, Ahmed? You're making his life easier.
Yeah.
He owes you.
I didn't know that.
Not really, because there's less work to be done.
Okay.
You owe me.
You're here to talk us through the headlines.
Yeah.
Let's have a look at the first one. It's from The Sun. Especially for Stu. This is a story, isn't it nice? This is a story saying that Michelle thinks her and Stu could re-release the classic Kylie and Jason song. Is there any chance of that at all?
Well, they could, couldn't they? I mean, obviously the dynamic of their relationship is going to change when they, or shift, let's say, when they leave the house. Possibly right the way back to Macclesfield, who knows? But, I mean, they could do any number of things. It's a question of whether something like this would make them more or less interesting to people.
Yeah.
I suspect there are better songs they could do, I feel, anyway. Possibly more appropriate to the to the state they might be in when they leave.
Go on, you've got something coming here. I don't know,
Bad Out of Hell, possibly. Oof. Stuart Solo, or I don't know. Don't go breaking my heart.
Yeah, Stuart Solo. Do you see them coming out and doing quite well? I mean, if they play it right from a press point of view, would they go with, say, something like OK and or something like that and do a few?
I'd hazard a guess here on Michelle, you know, being quite keen on selling their wedding that she obviously dreams about to her.